Guys, it's April and happy Halloween. We are going to be finishing this adorable version of Poltergeist. And we're going to be starting with the part that I've kind of been avoiding for a little while because I wasn't 100% sure how I wanted to do the TV screen, but I am just going to start and kind of hope it turns out. Hi, Elizabeth. Welcome. So, what am I going to do? I am going to first pull up my sleeves. Think I'm going to start with a black and give a little better definition to some of these hands. Just kind of giving them a little bit of depth. Because you have pressure points in your palm. So, like this part and this part would put more pressure rather than this part. So, this part would be a little bit darker on the screen, at least in my version of reality. So, kind of. Want to darken that up, and there might be a few fingers that would press in a little bit more too. I'm choosing to believe that some of these are right-handed and some of these are left. And then I'm going to start with the dark indigo, and I want to do the start of those old school tubed television static lines. So I'm just going to kind of like might have to come through and darken a few. But I kind of just want to get a base. Oops. Honestly, I think this is going to be the most tedious part of this whole process. So, how did you enjoy Psycho, Elizabeth? It's been years since I've seen that one, any version. Should probably be using the other side of this so I'm not smearing the pastel. So then I'm going to go back through with the Helio Blue Reddish. My idea is to just slowly go through keep adding till we are at a good place. have to keep reminding myself that this is a TV screen. So it's going to be casting light. There's not going to be shadows on the same way than if it was a regular object. So we do want to keep it on the lighter side, but we still want to have those dark notes of snow. I'm going to color in the rest of the TV and see how I feel about where this ends up. I might be further modifying it. Because it's not quite where I want it to be. It's got the essence of it. It's just, it's not quite there. Some of this. Starting with the black. Hit. parts of the TV, I know for sure we're gonna lose to some shadows. And then I've got the dark indigo that I'm just going to expand out from that. This is the light ultramarine that I'm adding in for a bit of that glow. I think for the most part, just gonna play with the black and the indigo. Because to me, these kind of TVs are that wood tone, so it would be darker. There would be some reflecting just because of the finish. But it wouldn't be that kind of plasticky reflection that you get with modern televisions. And it wouldn't be as dark because now we use that black plastic. It's one of those things I don't want to go too black too quickly. But also, it probably does have a darkness to it. That needs to be added. Try not to shake the whole table as I do this. I am being very aggressive with the black. And some of this is gonna change as I get those orbs added in. And the mist. Yeah, I'm not being careful to get a smooth kind of feel to it, because you do want some of that texture that you were mentioning. Now, I am noticing that my monitor and my camera is kind of flashing things out a little bit. A little closer to where we sit. See, the problem is I'm working with such a high contrast image that it keeps trying to set the contrast so you can get it all, but it doesn't do it very well. Like I said, it might be a combination of my computer monitor and the auto corrections the camera's trying to do. Yeah, 'cause see, when I change the contrast, you lose the details. There we go. Can see some of it just a little bit better. Okay. I'm gonna start adding wonder if I'll have to use a mix. This is the white pastel pen. can't decide if I'm liking what this is doing or if it's just kind of making it feel dirty. So I think I want to have maybe something right about here.
Thank you.
That's kind of what I was going for because, in I don't remember which Poltergeist movie it is. You kind of get a lot of this, like, the smoke kind of takes on a little bit of shape and whimsy and I'm attempting to kind of emulate that, even though it's kind of going a little bit of its own way right now. And that might be even better than me trying to control it. Goodness. Maybe keep layering and messing. Trying to build up But at some point, I'm just gonna have to call it good. Right? Do I like where it's sitting? Do I want to call it? Course, I just got everything everywhere. I do kind of like the. It's not as controlled of a mist as I was originally going for, but I think I kind of like where it's sitting right now. And part of that, I think, is just because of the texture of the paint on the page. Is controlling how the pastel sits. So it's not even going into places I thought it was gonna go to, and it's like pulling and collecting in other places, and it's giving you this multi-layered effect, which I think is kind of cool. Think I kind of want to build up some of this just a little bit more. A little bit more terrifying and splodgy. This could get dangerous. And I may need to put the Posca pen down before I take it too far. Apparently, there's such a thing as too much, which I don't think I understand. Try real quick. And I'm reaching out through the television for her. Because we had, what, that one spirit who was attempting to control all of the other spirits from the people who had been buried in the house, on, well, in the land that the house was sitting on top of. I think that is where I want to leave it. See if I can refocus. You were supposed to focus on my hand, which then is focused on the picture. There we go. I'll definitely have to take a picture of it so you can see how I am seeing it in person. But otherwise, it was a fun new technique to play out with. I'm learning how pastels and acrylic paint kind of play together and don't play together. I attempted the static on the TV, and I think it looks a little bit more staticky in person, though I do think on the screen it looks pretty fun as well. But like I said, I will take a picture of it. I will put it up on social medias, all of them, Instagram, Twitter, and of course on the community tab here so you can get a feel for it. But I am going to leave it here. I like it. I want to thank each and every one of you for coming and hanging out with me this wonderful Halloween day. I'm so excited. I will probably put a poll up for what I want to color next, or I might just choose something because we're just going to have November and then we're going to get into December and I want to do some holiday theme thing. So I might just choose something short myself to do for a couple weeks in November and then have a holiday color poll up for you guys to choose. I haven't quite decided. So look for some kind of, I will either post what I'm going to color next or I will post a poll on what I should color next. So look for those on my community tab and on Twitter. So if you don't follow me on Twitter or if you don't, you're not subscribed to me here on this channel, highly recommend that you do that so that you can get information on what's coming up next. Otherwise, I hope you have a wonderful rest of your holiday, Halloween day. I hope lots of candy and frights in your future. And I want to thank all of you who came and talked to me in the chat, especially you, Elizabeth, because you are wonderful. I'm glad you showed up. Otherwise, I will see you next weekend, same time, same place. So Sunday, 11 Central. However, I think next weekend might be daylight savings, the switch over. So things might be a little offset because that's always what happens. So make sure that you know when that time change happens, and if you're not in a zone where the time changes, it's going to be an hour different than what it is normally. But otherwise, I heart your beautiful faces and I hope to see you again. Bye.